In this figure, we're going to examine the hepatic portal system. And this is one of a very small handful of portal systems found in the human body. Now, before we do so, let's look at typical systemic circulation so that we can compare it to this sort of atypical portal system. Now, in a typical systemic circulation, the left side of the heart down here delivers blood through the arterial circuits into capillary beds, where our oxygen diffuses out to supply the cells of that tissue. Carbon dioxide would actually diffuse in, and that blood's going to then be depicted as more bluish due to that deoxygenation, and it's going to travel through veins back to the heart, the right side of the heart in this case, to be repressurized and driven through the pulmonary circuit to reestablish the high oxygen and low carbon dioxide levels we need prior to sending it out to the systemic tissues again. Now, in a portal system, up here in the main figure, we actually have two capillary beds in series. In other words, one after another. And in this case, it's adaptive in helping maintain the blood levels of nutrients in a postprandial state. And postprandial refers to right after a meal. And so we can see we have our arterial circuit supplying blood flow to our GI tract. Our GI tract, we want to think of this largely as the small intestine, as that's where most of our nutrients are being absorbed. We see that occurring here. And they're being absorbed into these fenestrated capillaries. We're losing some oxygen, so we're going to transition towards purple. We need an intermediate color here because we can't go straight to blue because we've got two capillary beds in series. So we're going to become partially deoxygenated. This blood is going to become very nutrient rich right after a meal. And that's going to travel through this portal vessel known as the hepatic portal vein. Now, that high nutrient level doesn't make it into the general systemic circulation because of this second capillary bed at the liver. We have liver sinusoids, which are these very large, very permeable capillaries that allow those nutrients to diffuse out, and they are rapidly taken up by hepatocytes, the functional cells of the liver, to be stored. This dramatically reduces our nutrient levels here. You can see the little light-colored circles here, our nutrient levels. They fall dramatically. We come out of the liver into our hepatic veins, and we're back into our systemic circulation here, back to the heart. Now, you might notice this other hepatic artery coming into the liver. Well, think about this. If about 3/4 of our blood flow is from the portal vein, again, to accommodate those enormous nutrient loads in the postprandial state, but that's partially deoxygenated. So we're going to actually have duplicate or additional circulation that's directly derived from the aorta to fuel the aerobic respiration of the liver, right? Because this is going to be oxygenated blood coming directly into that liver, helping to maintain that aerobic function. And again, it's all gets combined here at the liver and then returns through the hepatic veins into the general circulation. Last thing to say here is that the nutrients absorbed are largely the carbohydrates and amino acids, the monosaccharides and amino acids. The fats, if you recall, are absorbed into the lymphatic system at the GI tract wall. That's going to bypass this system and deliver those fats directly into the venous circulation where those lymphatic vessels join up in the large systemic veins in the upper thorax. And so our blood fat levels actually do rise dramatically in the postprandial state as opposed to those of the monosaccharides and the amino acids.